Hey guys, how's it going? I'm your host Jared Bronstein, and welcome back to another video here for you on Life's Biggest Questions. We look to answer any and all questions you may have for us, and try our best to make it informative and entertaining as well. If you think you'd enjoy this type of content, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well as that bell so you can be notified when we post our newest videos. If this is your first time here, welcome. Drop us a comment below saying hi, and ask a question you've always wanted answered. It might be used for our next video idea. I'm also going to be responding to some comments from a previous video as we wrap up this one, but for now, we need to dive into the following question. How can we stop a hurricane? Before we talk about ways to stop a hurricane, let's talk about what a hurricane exactly is. The definition of a hurricane is, I quote, a storm with a violent wind, in particular, a tropical cyclone in the Caribbean. Now, the only difference between a hurricane, typhoon, and a cyclone is where the storm forms. Hurricanes, specifically, are produced in the Caribbean, and for something to be considered a hurricane, and not just a tropical storm, winds need to exceed 73 miles per hour. And following the devastating effects of Hurricane Dorian, which, according to reports, has left 44 dead in the Bahamas, 5 dead in the US, and hundreds of thousands of people without shelter, food, water, and electricity, we decided to look into how we could stop these destructive storms from happening in the first place. With experts predicting climate change to cause hurricanes to become more destructive and frequent as the years go on, we may need to find ways to stop them in their tracks before they get to the point that Dorian got to. And it's something experts have been researching for many, many years, including the idea of even nuking them. And no, I'm not talking about President Donald Trump. During the 50s, the idea was allegedly suggested by a US scientist, but the thought of actually going through with it was slim to none. Between 1962 and 1983, the US government tried out a theory called Project Stormfury. The idea here was to drop silver iodide into hurricane rain clouds in hopes of reducing the strength of the winds and the storm's intensity. Although they saw some positive results, it was determined in the 1980s that it wasn't as successful as they initially thought because 1. Hurricanes contain too much natural ice and too little supercooled water, and 2. The positive results they saw from the experiment stemmed from the inability to discriminate between the expected results of human intervention and the natural behavior of hurricanes, according to an official government website. Now, there are other interesting theories out there that could potentially be used to help us stop a hurricane. One of these theories is cooling seawater by using a system called Salter Sink. Patented by British marine engineer and professor Stephen Salter and Microsoft founder Bill Gates, the idea would be to have hundreds of thousands of these systems strategically placed throughout the oceans to prevent surface level water temperatures from rising, which is one of the main ingredients needed for a hurricane. The Salter Sink is a large pump which would be powered by ocean waves that pushes the hot surface level water down toward the bottom of the ocean, we're talking at least 500 feet down, to mix with the cooler waters. Although the idea here technically makes sense, the company released a statement back in 2012 on their website that said, I quote, "Although that project returned some interesting early results, in order for hurricane suppression technology to become a reality, it would require much more extensive testing and research that's better suited for a university or government research group to pursue." In other words, they saw some positive results, but still have long ways to go. There's also the theory that pumping billions of tons of sulfate gases into the planet's upper atmosphere would cool down our oceans because the gases would block some light from the sun. It's actually been scientifically proven before, according to the journal Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, that states, I quote, "The explosive volcanic eruptions of Katami, Alaska, June 1912, and El Chicón, Mexico, April 1982, preferentially loaded the northern hemisphere with aerosol, and they were followed by the least active hurricane seasons on record in 1914 and the least active hurricane season in the satellite observation period in 1983. It sounds great, but here's where the problem lies. Obnoxious amounts of sulfate being pumped into our Earth's atmosphere would affect the ozone, which protects us, the people, from the sun's deadly radiation. So unless we decide to bathe in sunscreen every morning, this isn't really an option. But the idea is proven to work, so who's to say scientists can't find other gases with similar positive effects that wouldn't be so detrimental to our planet? And going back to the sunscreen thing, that was a joke. No amount of sunscreen would protect us from the high amounts of radiation that would come if we produced that much sulfate in our atmosphere. So to wrap it up, there's technically no way to stop a hurricane, but that doesn't mean science isn't close. We found ways technically to do so, but it would cost us our planet and our lives. Something we aren't willing to trade for. Well, at least I'm not. With that being said, the idea is definitely there. Whether it's natural gases or the Salter Sink that we use, I think it won't be much longer before we ultimately do find a way to stop hurricanes from causing as much damage and destruction as Katrina, Irma, and most recently Dorian has caused us over the years. As always, we love hearing from you guys, so please do drop us some comments down below. Which one of these methods do you think would be the most effective? Do you think any of them would be? Let me know down below. For now, let's respond to some comments from the video, are Category 6 hurricanes possible? Lone Wolf said, "I think they should add a Category 6. We may even need a Category 7 in the future. Well, at the rate we're going at, they say climate change are going to make hurricanes much, much worse and destructive. Again, a Category 5 is just catastrophic and it accounts for X amount and higher, but I mean, technically, if it goes up by every 20 miles per hour or so, approximately, why can't we add Category 6, 7, 8, 9, 10? Miles James 13601 said, is a hurricane worse than a tornado? Yes. Although tornadoes can reach much higher winds per hour, they're usually not as destructive. Some tornadoes can last up to an hour, but most don't. Whereas hurricanes can last for days or even weeks. Some hurricanes are even known to spawn tornadoes. Reginald Assayer said, what if everything LBQ discussed became real? Well, if you watch any of our videos, I think it'd be safe to say we would have died a long, long time ago, considering how most of our videos end up with the inevitable death of humans. And that does it for this video, guys. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. If you guys enjoyed this video, let us know by giving us a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and of course, subscribe and ring that bell. You guys gotta drop us some comments down below with which method you think would be the most effective to stop hurricanes, and we'll speak soon.